The Department of City Planning created this video to explain some of New York City's ongoing resiliency work and to solicit input on strategies to adapt your neighborhood to flood risk. As Hurricane Sandy reminded us, New York City faces serious risk from coastal storms. Scientists have observed that climate change is causing sea levels to rise, which is increasing the intensity and frequency of flooding. Storms like Sandy will be more likely, but in some neighborhoods, flooding is already a common occurrence. New York City's waterfront includes a variety of diverse neighborhoods, which face different flood risk. These coastal communities have been working with the city and other partners to build resiliency. The ability to withstand, recover, and emerge even stronger following a storm.
Our work is part of the city's effort to build multiple lines of defense from coastal flooding. This includes providing emergency services to make sure people are safe when a flood occurs, creating breakwaters and wetlands to reduce the force of waves, building seawalls and bulkheads to block floodwaters from spreading inland, hardening utilities and infrastructure to prevent the loss of power and other services, and promoting flood-resilient construction. No single strategy can protect against all storms, so a variety of preventative measures is important. The city's goal is to advance flood-resilient design and enable neighborhoods to become more resilient. Who defines flood risk and how? The Federal Emergency Management Agency, or FEMA, produces flood insurance rate maps, which identify the floodplain. These maps estimate the expected elevation of floodwaters and the area at high risk for flooding. This information is the basis for flood insurance premiums and building code requirements. New buildings and major alterations in the floodplain must meet specific codes set by FEMA and enforced by the Department of Buildings. These codes are intended to protect lives and property by limiting basements and cellars and requiring all living space to be above the flood elevation. For residential buildings, any space below the flood elevation must be designed to allow floodwaters to enter and exit the structure without causing damage. Commercial or mixed-use buildings have the option of designing ground floors that are impermeable to water so that businesses can continue to operate at the street level. Buildings built to these codes survived Hurricane Sandy with minimal damage. Unfortunately, most of the buildings in the floodplain were built before these codes were adopted and are more susceptible to damage. Many owners would like to retrofit their buildings to these standards in order to reduce risk and the cost of flood insurance. However, retrofitting can be expensive and can also be complicated by zoning. Zoning is a planning tool used to create an orderly pattern of development across neighborhoods. It does this by laying out what uses can occur on a property and placing limits on the size and shape of buildings. These limits are referred to as the zoning envelope, which regulates yards, distance between buildings, building height, and the maximum amount of floor area. Zoning envelopes vary by neighborhood in order to reflect their character. When today's zoning resolution was adopted in 1961, flood risk was not as immediate or well understood. In 1983, FEMA issued the first flood maps for New York City and building code for flood-resistant construction was first adopted. After Sandy, city planning developed zoning rules to allow property owners to meet new higher flood elevations issued by FEMA. These rules were adopted by the City Council in 2013 on a temporary emergency basis to allow recovery from the storm, recognizing that a more permanent strategy would be needed in the future. We are now revisiting our interim rules to make sure they work for all types of buildings. One issue we've learned from homeowners is that buildings that cannot be physically elevated, either because they are too large or because they are attached to their neighbors, are hard to retrofit to new building code standards while keeping the same amount of living space. This means that homeowners may end up having to lose a portion of their home or even a whole apartment when making their building resilient. We are examining how zoning can make it easier for people to protect their homes and allow neighborhoods to thrive.
We want to hear about your experiences and how you envision the future of your neighborhood in the floodplain. We encourage you to email us at resilientneighborhoods@planning.nyc.gov for more information on our work and to get involved in the discussion. Visit nyc.gov/resilientneighborhoods. We look forward to hearing from you.